1984 HA47.
So because it's an 84 model and a HA47, it's got the old 2H in it. So it's got 130,000 kilometres, but I don't know if that's accurate or not because the speedo stopped working however long ago. So could have 300,000. You never know. So I think the first thing this needs is a good old wash. Get rid of all the dirt and crap on it. So that's the cruiser all nice and clean. No more dirt on it. There was a heck of a lot of dirt underneath. The cab had a heap under it, a lot on it. The interior's gotten to clean. It was disgusting before. Now it's all really nice, polished up and cleaned. All the gauges and switches are really good. Driver's seat's in really good nick, but the passenger seat's a little bit ruined. It blows a little bit of smoke at idle. It's not too bad though. There's no smoke when you rev it, so that's good. Runs nice and clean. Engine bay got itself a little bit of a clean as well. The old 2H ticks over nicely. Goes really well, nice and smooth. Comes back to idle. So we've got a slight problem with the cruiser. It's a bit big for the shed. Now it fits in height-wise and width-wise. It's about, I don't know, an inch or two each side of the mirror and about 3 inches from the top of the shed to the headboard. But it doesn't fit in length. So this cabinet here, well, it's kind of in the way. So we're going to move that over into the corner there, onto that wall, and then we'll have some room to park the 40 in here. Well, it was a bit of a tight squeeze. There's about an inch between the wall and the 40. There's not much room between the doors. Not much room in the back either, just enough to get in and out. And you kind of have to climb onto this kind of cabinet here to get out of the door. It only opens that far, so it's a bit hard to get out, but you know, got it in. It's gonna keep it out of the weather, keep the water out of the roof. And yeah, now I've got Suzuki and my new pride and joy. So I thought, what's a better name for this than Dusty? So it's the 464 beige, you know, quite a dusty color. It's always going to be off-road, it's going to be dusty, it's going to be muddy, so I thought Dusty was the best name you could have for it. So it's got a 2H under the bonnet, and behind that is the H41 4-speed gearbox. Now it takes a bit of getting used to that 4-speed. All the gears are a bit funny, different places, and it's a tight gearbox. You've got to be really precise. But all in all, I'm really happy with the drivetrain in this thing. So the plan for the old girl is to strip it right back to the chassis and almost do a nut and bolt rebuild. So I want to strip the cab down, strip everything out of the interior. Now, it's painted in 464 beige at the moment, which is the original colour. It's just faded a bit. So once I pull everything out and fix all the rust, which is in the normal places like where the back wall and the bottom tub connect, I'll respray it in that original 464 beige. The tray's a bit buckled, and it's really quite rusted out through the kind of passenger section at the front here. It's rusted out through there, it's rusted out around the back. So we might build a new tray for it, or try and keep the outer bits of the tray and redo the inside with timber or steel.
So the inside of the 40, well, the door card's, well, there's no door card left on the driver's side. The driver's seats, it is really in good nick. There's no tears, nothing, hasn't sagged, that's really good. The passenger seat on the other hand, well, you can almost stick your whole hand through the bottom of it. So that needs reupholstering and fixed up.
So because it's a late model 47, as you can see, it's got the taco and the full dash, the sought after model. So everything works, all the switches work, all the fan, the pull for fresh air, pull for heat, all that works. The only thing that doesn't work in here is the radio. Now, not much use for a radio in a 40. You can't really hear it. So that's gonna get pulled out, probably stuck on the shelf because they're super rare, the radios. And we might put some switches in there.
There'll be a roof console going up in the top here. Now, that'll give you a lot more storage because there's really no storage in these things apart from the glove box. It's a decent sized glove box, goes all the way back. But other than that, there's no storage in them. So up the top here will give you a lot more storage, put maps and everything.
So it's got the factory dash pad up here and some larger factory fitted mirrors. So the cruiser's running the original 16 inch split rims, and wrapped around that is the Dunlop SP road grippers. They're a Butte tyre, they're 7.5 inch wide and 16 inch. So they come around to about a 32 inch tall tyre. So the wiring's a little bit of a mess. Lots of things have been added, lots of things have been cut out, so typical farm ute, that'll all have to be fixed. Could do with a little bit of a tickle of the fuel screw, get a little bit more power out of it, but all in all, can't beat them. So it's the original steel roof that's painted white, and it's got a lot of rust in this corner there. There's also some rust there just above the kick vent in the corner where the bonnet closes. So at the start of 2021, the Suzuki's going to get moved out of the shed for a few years, and the 40, well, it's going to get fully rebuilt in here. Stripped down to the chassis, all the body panels off, and restored back to new.